Hey, this is Chuck with BMW Blog, and in this video, we're going to show you how to get into your BMW i3 with a completely dead key fob, and perhaps more importantly, how to drive your car with a totally dead key fob. Watch this. Step one is to remove the physical key BMW is hidden within the key fob for a circumstance just such as this, when the physical key fob battery is dead. On the back side of the key fob is a little tiny button right there. Smash this. While smashing that button, pull on this little tab, and right in here is the actual physical key that you can use to get into your BMW i3. So take the key, push this little button right here, pull. Step two is to take off the removable cap that will reveal the door keyhole that is on the door handle of the BMW i3. Come on over to this part. And underneath here, you have a little tiny spot for that key. Shove it in there until you meet some resistance. Lift back, and it pops the cap off. Once you have that cap popped off, then you can put your car key in the locking mechanism and open the door. And that's with a completely dead key fob. Make sure you don't lose this piece. Note at this point, you may accidentally set the car alarm off, in which case you really need to hurry up and get the key fob in the right position by the steering column so you can start the car and turn the alarm off. So this is the cap. Just make sure you're very careful with it because this little piece here can bend and you can break that. And BMW sells the replacement piece. It's just a black piece of plastic, and then you have to have it painted body color. So make sure you don't damage it and or lose it. Or you're gonna have to go order one and then have to have it painted. So if I take it off, I like to immediately put it back on so I can't lose it. I find if you look at these two little notches here and you hook them in here and snap it down, that it works a lot better, and then you're less likely to break this little tiny piece here and then have to buy a whole new one. So just slightly hook the top on and then snap the bottom on, and then you want to make sure that it's nice and flush and you can't really tug it off, because when you're going 55 miles an hour down the road, you don't want it to come off. Also, if you have a newer BMW from 2008 and on that has a battery key fob, the procedure is very much the same, just slight variations on where you find the actual lock cover and how you get to it. It is worth noting here that if you have the BMW Connected app, that you can actually use the app to open your car, but it requires a subscription service, an account set up, and it's not going to actually start the car, but it can get you in the car, which can save you the first few steps. But if you have the app, get to this point here, and then I'll show you how to start the car. Right, so I've gotten in the car. I usually put the key back in the key fob so that you don't lose it. So now, if I step on the brake and hold the key fob in my hand, it won't do anything. In fact, the car is saying that the remote battery control is empty. It will not start the car. So on the right hand of the column of the car is this little tiny key mark. You hold your car key up here, then you step on the brake and push the start stop button. And there you have. There you have started your car without anything. You have this warning error that says remote control, hold remote control on the steering column. We hope you like this short little video on the BMW i3 and how to get into and drive your car with a completely dead key fob. If you like this, watch our next video and we'll show you how to change the battery on your key fob so that you don't have to go through the procedure that I just showed you. And also, don't forget to like and subscribe to our BMW Blog YouTube channel. Cheers.